She played the squeaky clean mum Olivia Walton on the hit television show, but there is much more to Michael Learned. She only took on the famous role because she was broke, and for years she hid a secret drinking problem. As usual, Craig Bennett got all the goss for this Australian television exclusive.
On paper, the Waltons should never have been a hit on Australian television. It was a show about a Depression-era family living in the mountains of Virginia in America, and it bore little resemblance to the bush and surf of our 70s sunburnt country. But Aussie families in their droves plonked themselves down in front of the telly on a Sunday night to watch the day-to-day lives of the wholesome Walton family.
Ma, would you like some cornbread?
Yes. This food is good.
Thank you very much, La.
Michael Learned is forever etched in television history as the loving and loyal matriarch Olivia Walton. And it was a role the actress didn't warm to at first.
My agent kept saying, I want you to go up for this role. And I kept saying, but why? I'm not right for it. He kept insisting, and finally I did, and God's hand was on my shoulder.
Getting that role was really a lifesaver for you. It came along just at the right moment.
Sure did. I was living in a motel for $12 a night, and I was going through a divorce. I was drinking too much. I had three kids to support, and I just got lucky.
Tell me if this is true, that you were horribly hungover when you went to audition.
Yes, I was.
So how did you cope?
Well, Richard and Ralph were testing with me. I didn't have to audition. We were all in costume, and so I just zeroed in on them. And they were so... it was like we just all clicked.
Author Earl Hamner Jr. created the Waltons, and he is the inspiration for the character of John Boy. The series was based on his own upbringing in the 30s, but this was the 70s. Women were making their mark in both the workplace and in the home. And Michael and Earl were often at loggerheads over the direction of Olivia.
Michael was very aware of the fact that she would be held up as a model for women, and she didn't want to appear so perfect that a woman couldn't measure up in her own way.
I remember once talking to him, and I said, didn't your mother ever do anything wrong? Didn't she ever scold the wrong child or do anything? And he said, no. And then I said, you're lying. And he said, well, sometimes if she got really upset, she wouldn't speak to us for a couple of days. And I thought, okay.
That was a secret to the success of the series, that I wasn't off somewhere the almighty producer. I listened to the actors. I adapted to their needs. And in turn, they were cooperative enough with me to do their very best job.
The Waltons were America's number one squeaky clean TV family. The same couldn't be said for the actors who played the patriarch, John Walton, and the lovable grandpa. Both were prone to dropping their dacks at any opportunity.
I saw more of Will Gere's ass than I ever wanted to see.
What was
but he
it
had
about?
Such a good time doing it. They didn't do it in front of the kids or anything, but they were naughty.
The winner is Michelle Learned, the Waltons.
Michael won three Emmys for her portrayal of Olivia, but her masculine name remained an issue.
I'm stunned, and the name is Michael.
For the first 5 years of the series, she was billed as Miss Michael Learned, so viewers would not be confused about her gender. She says her parents may have enjoyed a drink or two, or maybe three, after her birth.
I think they'd had a few martinis and they thought it would be cute. I don't know.
Michael made the decision to hang up Olivia's apron after 7 years.
You know, it had gotten to the point where I felt that I really was going more coffee, John, time for bed, kids, and pass the salt, please. And just 15 hours of that got to be really a bore, frankly. They'd put me through menopause. Where else were they gonna go with it, you know? And they kindly gave me tuberculosis so I could come back.
Oh, that was
they
amazing.
Didn't kill me, yeah.
As she alluded to earlier, Michael had struggled with alcohol addiction before and while on the Waltons. She credits her on-screen husband, Ralph Waite, for saving her life, saying he once grabbed her by the shoulders and told her she had a problem.
I just thought, this is crazy. Why am I drinking? I'm all alone. You know, when you start drinking alone, you know you're in trouble. So I got off the train early. I wasn't liking going to bed a little bit you know, off. And so that was it. And my youngest son had said, Mom, you know, when you drink wine, you're different. And I thought, I didn't like that, so.
Do you know why you were drinking?
I suffer from depression, and I was going through a divorce from a man I had spent half my lifespan with and whom I loved. And I was just kind of lost. When you're married at 17, you don't really have an identity. So my identity was wound up with my marriage and my husband. And the only reason I talk about it is because I want people to know that you can get your life together. I'm having a wonderful old age.
And you're proof positive, too, that you can turn things around.
Exactly. But if you're willing to do the work, you can really have a great life.
Now, you have an Australian connection, which maybe not a lot of people know about.
I do.
Could you explain that?
Well, my son's mother-in-law is Helen Reddy. So her daughter, Tracy, was born in Australia as well. And I adore her. She's the most beautiful daughter-in-law anyone could ever ask for. And Helen and I are good friends, yeah.
Do you see Helen from time to time?
A lot. Every holiday, every family gathering, we're always together. And
I wonder who might play you in the movie on Helen Reddy's life.
I'm not in the movie, but my granddaughter, Lily, sings in it.
That is fabulous.
Lovely voice.
Helen's so proud of Lily.
Yes.
Absolutely
Lily's
gorgeous.
Great.
After three failed marriages, Michael found a long-lasting happiness with lawyer John Doherty. Last year, the couple celebrated their 31st wedding anniversary. And she continues to work. She recently starred in the film Second Act.
I must have seen you somewhere. I never forget the face of a pretty woman.
Oh, please. That's a terrible line.
Then there is her most loved television role and her on-screen family.
It gave me a second family who are still my family today, so, yeah.
And the workload was
a blessing.
Huge.
Yes, it was. The hours are long. And when you have three kids of your own, you're spending more time with kids that aren't your own than you are with your own. So that was hard sometimes for them, for my kids, and for me. It's an honor, really, to have been part of that show.
Hi, everybody.
Good night, Mama.